Hey guys, it's Matt. I know it's been quite a long time since I've been on YouTube, and I'm just coming on because I kind of owe you an explanation as to where I went, why I disappeared, what I'm doing now, why I'm all of a sudden wearing clothes, and I just want to come on, chat to you, just tell you everything that's happened and explain it. So it's been maybe, I want to say, 4 or 5 months since I uploaded a YouTube video, and there's probably, I want to say, 2 reasons why I stopped and kind of fell off the face of the earth. So, number one, I'm getting like a little bit emotional here. I guess I started to kind of struggle creatively with like what I was going to do. Every week I needed a new recipe idea, and I kind of got sucked into doing things that maybe I wasn't that happy with. Like I was like, oh, I'm going to make something unicorn themed, and deep down inside, I guess I was trying to chase YouTube views when actually I didn't really enjoy making unicorn themed pastries. And it got to a point where I was kind of like, I don't really want to be doing this anymore. Like, as much as I want to be successful on YouTube and I want that to be my career, like, I'm not creatively happy with what I'm doing, if that makes sense. And it sounds like a very weak answer as to why I stopped, but I was feeling a bit anxious about going to film YouTube videos because I wasn't happy with what I was putting out. I didn't think it really represented kind of who I was or what I wanted to do in the future. And then there's kind of the whole topless element to the whole thing. And obviously I was Topless Baker for 4 years and it was amazing. I'm so glad I did it. I had so much fun doing it and I had opportunities to go around the world and go on TV, etc., etc. And it was an amazing vehicle to get me to where I am now. But I kind of grew up, I was like 27, 28, and I started to feel a bit uncomfortable. Obviously, I'd been half naked my whole career, and then, you know, I was going to events, and I was like, oh, I'm like stripping off my apron, and there's professional chefs around me, and I just, I don't know, I felt uncomfortable being topless, and I thought, I can't do this anymore. Like, I'm not happy creatively with what I'm producing, and I just feel uncomfortable being topless because I feel like I've moved on from that. I've kind of grown up. And so that came to a head and I was like, I don't have any more ideas. I don't want to be topless anymore. I just need to stop. And I should have said that. I should have explained that to you a bit earlier, but at the time I was like, no, I need to stop. Now at the same time of stopping YouTube, I was really, really focusing on my Instagram. So I don't know if you follow me on Instagram, but became like obsessed with these little 60-second Instagram videos, like making cute little colorful dainty desserts, and it just became like my everything. It's all I did all week, and I was loving it because I was trying new flavors, I was trying new skills, I was really pushing my own creative boundaries. And the great thing about it is people were really enjoying it. So like I was successful on Instagram, and the flip side of that was on YouTube, you know, I traveled to London, I brought my equipment, I was making videos that I wasn't really happy with. It wasn't that successful, and like deep down, if I look at it, like I know my YouTube channel wasn't doing that well, and I wanted to be a successful YouTuber, you know, I wanted to be doing 50, 60, 100,000 video views, because you kind of get that in your head, and I wasn't doing that, and that upset me. And so I was like, right, I'm gonna stop because I'm not enjoying it, I'm not doing well, and I'm just gonna focus on Instagram. Which then leads me on to this. So I was doing all the Instagram stuff. Obviously I wasn't topless on Instagram because I was doing like Instagram stories every day and people are asking, why are you topless? Like, oh, we wanna see your body, you know, the comments I usually get. And I was like, right, I need to change my name. I'm not gonna be Topless Baker anymore. So I went through this whole rebrand and I changed from Topless Baker to Matt Adlard, which is just me. And I don't know if you can see, but I got like a new logo, I got myself these fancy little chef jacket, but it was just the right time to make that move. I felt it fit like what I was doing in the image I had on Instagram, and it was something that I was gonna be comfortable doing on YouTube. So that, in a rather convoluted way, is an answer to the questions as to why I disappeared and what was happening. And you know, I just needed a reboot, I needed a rebrand, and I feel comfortable and excited in this new Matt Adlard branding. Now I totally appreciate that you guys might have subscribed to me and come from a video where I'm half naked and it's cheeky and it's sexy or whatever. But hopefully through watching my videos or you've been watching my Instagram stories or whatever, you've come to know me for me and you've enjoyed my personality and my attitude and my approach to cooking and just making it like fun and easy and approachable, and I just don't want it to be stressful. So hopefully you can appreciate that change and you'll stay with me. So then you might have a question that's like, what have you been doing then, Matt? Where you been? You haven't been making YouTube videos, what have you been doing? So the big life update is, I got married. I don't know if you've seen my bling. I got married 7 weeks ago, which was really exciting. I have been working on the rebrand, so new logo, new social channels, new website, all that stuff. Still busy on my Instagram, doing my Instagram stories, but there is one really exciting update which I want to tell you about, which is, depending on when you're watching this, I've just launched my new online baking school called Bake It Better.
And now for my next number, I'd like to return to the classics.
So Bake It Better is an online subscription-based baking school. So as a member, every single month, what you get is 3 in-depth recipe videos. You get the PDF recipes, the equipment list, you get access to a private community of all the other members, like a little baking community. You get live Q&As with me, and every month is a different topic. So you saw in that sizzle reel all the cakes. The first month is learning all about cakes, and then every month will be a new topic. So whether it's pastry, bread, pies, entremets, croissants, I mean, we're gonna cover absolutely everything. And it's for all skill levels. So whether you're a total amateur and you've never picked up a spoon in your life, or a total pro and you want some more advanced recipes, it caters to all skill levels. Now, the first question you're probably asked, because I was asking myself the same question, is why don't you just put it on YouTube for free and start your baking school online? And now there is a cost associated to being a member. It's about $12 a month. So it's as cheap as I could possibly make it. But the reason there is a cost is just because there's production costs to producing the videos. I wanted this to be like as high end as possible because I wanted different camera angles, beautiful imagery, so you can really learn about the topic we're talking about. And there's a place for a YouTube video where it's, you know, 12 minutes and quick and there's kind of adverts surrounding you, but this is its own dedicated website where you can skip, fast forward, play, pause, whatever, and just learn at your own speed in a really in-depth video. So it's not a 6 minute video about a cake, it's like a 35 minute video about cake, so that you understand every single detail and really can grow as a baker. And so that's the main reason that there's a cost associated to it. And as a member, you get more than just the videos though. You get all the PDFs that you can download forever and keep those recipes. You get access to the baking community. We do live Q&A. So I was trying to go kind of above and beyond when it came to a membership to offer you as much as possible. I'm not in it to be a gazillionaire and take all your money. I just really want to cover the cost of the production and then make a really great environment for people to interact and for people to learn about baking. So yeah, that's quite a quick little explanation in a nutshell of Bake It Better. But if you want to find out more information, you can go to my new website, which is www.mattadlard.com. Very simple. But I am so excited to share this with you. I am really passionate about it and I'm excited to hear what you think and get your feedback. So if you've got any comments, please leave them below and any questions and I can answer those. But yeah, that's kind of everything for me. I just wanted to come on here, apologize for going missing, first of all, and just explain where I went, what happened, what I was thinking, say goodbye to Topless Baker, say hello to Matt Adlard, explain a bit about Bake It Better, and just catch up with you guys, because I've missed chatting to you. What else, one other bit of news? Oh, I might, if you're in the US, you might see me on the Food Network soon on your TV screens. I can't say any more, but if you follow me on Instagram, I'll announce that. when it happens, but just look out for me. And yeah, I think that's everything. Got any questions about Bake It Better? Just leave it in the comments and I will see you on YouTube sooner rather than later. All right, bye.